and how true is not enough. G'day guys, Pete Moriarty here, recording one of my favorite videos I've been looking forward to record, which is Outlook versus Gmail. Now my last video had some problems with the final result, so I'm re-recording this one. This is the second run through, but regardless, let me know where you're listening in from. You can just type in below your location, or if you'd like to plug your business, you're more than welcome to do that, or just go ahead and say hi. All right, let's jump straight into it. So when we move businesses over from the Microsoft world to the Google world, we get lots and lots of questions. We get questions about, well, why is Gmail better? We get questions about, why do I have to change? What can't I just keep things the same? And the interesting thing that we've found from working with literally thousands of business owners is that sometimes with a little bit of change, all you need is a helping hand. So if you've ever made a change in your life, from a technology perspective, that may have been moving from a PC to a Mac. It may have been moving from MYOB over to Xero. You would know that sometimes something that's scary, and you know, our crocodile brain goes, ooh, new things are scary and we should avoid them. Sometimes it's just a matter of being shown. And we very much believe that with Gmail, when we show most of our customers a few cool tricks that you can do inside of Gmail, they're very quick to make the move. Now, we've been responsible for over 15,000 employees making the switch over to Google, and that's across thousands of small businesses, primarily in Australia, but all over the world as well. And we're very confident that once you work out what's under the hood inside of Gmail, you'll be very quick to be ready to make the change. Now, first, let's dispel some myths and rumors and fear, uncertainty of doubt about what you can't do in Gmail. Number one is you can't work offline. Well, actually, you can work offline in Gmail because you can have up to the last 30 days of all of your emails synchronized to your Chrome browser, which will automatically allow you to respond, reply, and even compose new emails when you're offline. So if you're on a plane, if you're traveling, if you're sitting at the beach or in a cafe, that works fine. Number two, people complain about the conversation view in Gmail, and they kind of worry that, oh, well, everything's upside down and the new ones are at the top and the new emails are at the bottom instead of at the top like they are in Outlook. How do you manage that? Well, that's a very good question. Inside of Gmail requires a bit of a mind shift. The new emails, now that they're down the bottom, you've got to think of it a bit more like a message comment thread on Facebook. So if you're on Facebook, when you've got a new comment, they're always going to appear down the bottom, right? Well, Gmail works in the same way. And the reason for that is you might want to reply to one person and have a side conversation like you do on Facebook. Well, you do that in Gmail by selecting the email that you want to reply to and reply just to that one. Or if you want to reply to everyone, then you go right down the bottom and you reply there. It's a bit more of a modern way of dealing with email. And finally, people ask, well, you know, once I move over to Gmail, will people know that I'm on Gmail? Will people know that I'm using Google for my emails and it'll look unprofessional? Well, when you switch over to G Suite, which is Google's business accounts, well, you get all of your business domains. If you work with us, you have all your historical emails and folders and inbox and outbox brought across properly. And then from there, you're able to get everything done inside of a Gmail account with your business email address without anyone even knowing that you're working from Google in the background. Anyone who's outside of your business won't even know that you're using Google. It's all standards compliant and they look like normal emails coming and going. There's signatures, you can do shared mailboxes, public folders, all those kind of things. It's all part of it. Okay, let's talk about some of my favorite features. Now, storage with email is a challenge. Once you get over about 5 or 10 gigabytes of email, which is about a couple of years worth or 10,000 emails in your Outlook, it starts to slow down. Search crashes, the whole Outlook crashes. You start to run into problems with looking for emails from a couple of years ago. And what Google does to solve that problem is, because everything's online and Google's supercomputers are doing all of the heavy lifting with your email, it means that you never have a problem searching for old emails. You don't have to drag and drop things into folders for important emails and then archive the rest. You don't have to worry about searching for old emails on, where's my mobile phone gone, somewhere around here, here it is. You don't have to worry about searching for old emails on your mobile device because every single one of your emails is available in the cloud, and as long as you've got an internet connection on your mobile, you can search for that email from way back in 2011 from that client that emailed you about a quote, right? So from Google, you're able to access your emails from any device at any time. That's the basics, right? But you're also able to search any email and find any email, which is a big game changer. What that means is you don't have to bother deleting emails anymore because you've got such a massive mailbox that's never going to slow down no matter how many emails you throw at it. The second thing is it's never going to crash when you run out of when you run out of storage, because you get 30 gigabytes of storage with Google, but also if you need to search for old emails or go back in time and find anything, it's available from whatever device you're accessing from. So it makes it super, super easy and simple for you. Okay, we've covered storage, we've covered search and finding emails, and for the clever ones that are catching on, you'll realize that if you can search and find every single email and you know how easy it is to search with Google, well, then you don't even need to bother putting things into folders. Fry a noodle? A little bit. That gets most people. Okay, let's talk about how Google are using artificial intelligence inside of your email inbox. Now, if you're using Gmail in a personal or a consumer account, you may have seen inside the Gmail app on the mobile device canned responses down the bottom, or they're called suggested responses down the bottom of your email. So when an email is received, you get three options of suggested responses that Google thinks you might want to send back. So if the email says something along the lines of, is this approved? Then you probably have, yes, it's approved as one suggested response. One might be, no, this needs more work, or this needs a meeting. Number three might be, call me, right? And with one click of a button, you can press one of those suggested responses and it's automatically gonna reply, stick that in the compose window, allow you to edit it, and then bang, you can hit one button and send that off. So Google's using their artificial intelligence and machine learning to help save us time in our inbox, which is absolutely awesome. And that kind of feature just can't really come to the desktop in something like Outlook, because it needs Google supercomputers, it needs a live connection to the internet, and all of that magic kind of happening in the background behind the scenes. Now, what I love about these features is Google have now just announced a super duper cool one called Smart Compose. And Smart Compose will actually help you type emails for you. It will look at the person you're typing to, what your history is, what's coming up in your calendar. It will even suggest times that you might be able to meet as you're typing the emails, literally going to be in front of you typing the email for you. Very, very cool feature. If you want to check that out, just Google Smart Compose, or you can search our blog at itgenius.com. Okay, final one I wanted to cover is integrations. Now, with a desktop-based email platform, you've got to upload and download your file attachments all the time, and that can get a bit challenging if you're on a slower internet connection. Now, when you're working in Gmail, if you need to, for example, attach something from your Google Drive, with one button, you can automatically attach any file from your Google Drive, no matter how large it is, could be gigabytes and gigabytes, and you can automatically have a link to that file sent off to the person that you're sending to. Now, likewise, when you receive emails, you can click one button and automatically save any attachment in that email from right online, from in the browser, automatically into your Google Drive. Now, what that means is you don't have to bother uploading, you don't have to bother downloading, it's all happening automatically in the cloud. So great for slower internet connections, but also great for keeping your local machine nice and clean and tidy. And when you send that email, you don't have to wait the 3 minutes for the massive attachment to upload when you send it. So if you're in a creative business, if you're in maybe trade construction, you're receiving design files or CAD files or large PDFs or large zip files, maybe you're an accountant, you're receiving massive MYOB data files from those old clients who haven't upgraded yet, well, these are all useful features which happen right inside of the Google ecosystem. All right, lay your questions on me, guys. I know everyone has lots of questions. Anytime I mention Outlook versus Gmail, the guards come up and people start telling me all the ways where you won't take Outlook from my cold, dead hands. If you've got any questions or you want to go toe-to-toe on why you think Outlook's better, go ahead, pop a question down below. I am not afraid to take on your questions, and look forward to chatting to you soon. Until next time, take care. And of course, if you're interested in making the switch from the Microsoft world over to the Google world, our company, itgenius.com, specializes in helping businesses make the move. So you have training, dedicated consultants to help with the project management. We manage all of the migration of your historical data into the Google data, into the Google ecosystem, and we make sure that there's no downtime, there's no errors with the data. We error check it all and make sure that it's all perfect before we sign off and make sure that you're all across. So if you'd like any help at all with getting switched over to Google, or maybe you're already on Gmail and you just feel like your business isn't quite getting the most out of the platform, well, we'd be very happy to help. You can message our business page and I'll drop a link to that below, or you can email hello@itgenius.com and we'll be very happy to help you out. Till next time, catch you in the next video. Cheers. And help is not enough.